All records have been broken in the design and construction of the new Westland Army Corporation monoplane. Only 12 months ago, it was just a blueprint, and here's the first public demonstration of the completed machine. It's designed for Air Force cooperation with the Army, for observation, for taking photographs, and for directing gunfire. And because its pilot and observer must spend long periods in the air, everything has been designed for their comfort, with plenty of room in a specially heated super cabin. But the most extraordinary thing is the way the machine can almost stand still in the air, and then shoot off again at top speed. And though the top speed figure is still a secret, it's known to approach that of the fastest fighter. Because of its hovering capabilities, the new machine requires an extraordinarily small space in which to land. And as soon as its wheels touch the ground, powerful brakes check its run. A worthy new machine for the Royal Air Force.
And the Royal Air Force takes delivery of a new monoplane, the Westland Army Cooperation Type. Landing lights and the wheel spats are among the new features of this high-wing monoplane, which has an astonishingly short takeoff and a very wide range of speed. Her maximum is comparable with that which formerly could only be attained by single-seater fighters, and yet she can start for landing, as our illustration proves. Altogether a wonderful machine.
Of course, with the war on our doorstep, we're apt to think of the Royal Air Force in terms of fighters and bombers. But there are many other jobs for our numerous machines. Here are some Lysanders at an Army Cooperation aerodrome practicing picking up messages from the ground. Or they can drop supplies. The Lysander, in fact, is a very useful machine. It can be used for reconnaissance or indeed for bombing. So let's go for a little practice on the range. The more we take the offensive, the more bombers of all kinds we shall require. Canadian Air Force Squadron working under the Army Cooperation Command. For the time being, the Lysander is evidently their machine.
When a pilot gets into trouble over the channel, he can be sure of one thing. That if he bails out successfully, he has every prospect of being picked up in a very short while by the Air Sea Rescue Service. This great life-saving organization uses the most ingenious equipment. For instance, self-inflating rubber dinghies with food and drink and the means of keeping warm. Of course, speed in rescue is another vital point, and I can assure you that not a second is wasted from the time the news of a crash or a bailout reaches the operations room. One aircraft used is the good old walrus amphibian, here seen loading up with warm blankets and clothing in readiness for a call upon its service. The Lysander is another, carrying smoke bomb and dinghy container in the bomb racks. On sighting the pilot in the sea, the Lysander drops smoke bomb and dinghy and flies off to guide further aid to the spot. The walrus comes down to land on the sea and pick up the pilot. Picture illustrating one method of air sea rescue. The picture behind that official communique, one of our aircraft was lost, but the pilot is safe.
on the bomb.
And 15, 16 seconds.